Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I wanted to make this channel kind of like an informational, well, like educational and kind of fun channel. Mostly for awareness for cystic fibrosis. The abbreviation or short name for it is CF.
Something that you may not know. Here's
some do, may know, some may not, but back before modern technology,
the 80s or 90s,
or even, there were hundreds of thousands of babies born with CF. And the weird and cool part is that it was mostly found in northern European countries to fair-skinned people. And the way that they would test the babies to see if they had the disease is after they gave birth, and they, I guess, kind of cleaned up, you know, the little infant, they would lick their skin, either an arm or a leg, and if that skin was salty, then they would diagnose it for CF.
Because we as a people,
in our sweat, we lose almost all of our salt reserves in our bodies. If you see someone that, you know, adds like 2 gallons of salt to their food, good chance that they have CF. Because I know I add a lot of salt to almost everything I eat.
I don't add
that much salt when I cook, because obviously not everybody has my taste, so they don't have the high salt tolerance that I do. And what's even, and it's kind of like a rare disease, and the sad part is that it would
thousands upon thousands of infants
up to, from newborns all the way up to maybe 12 or 13 years old, if they were lucky, and which was a really bad thing. And I read a lot of medical journals that has to do with this. And they would have hundreds of thousands of babies just buried, like there were a ton of little baby graves. And what's rare about my disease is that, like I said, it usually
goes
to European countries,
the north,
to fair-skinned peoples. As you can see, I'm not fair-skinned. I don't have blonde hair or blue eyes. And
not
Northern European heritage. My part of my ancestors came from Spain and Portugal. I did an ancestry DNA test thing, you know, where you order that and
you have
like
to spit in a tube,
like up to a line, which is a lot of spit, by the way. And you send it in, and then like a week or 2 weeks later, it'll send your results to your account on AncestryDNA.com or Ancestry.com, whatever. And that's what I learned. And I'm 56%
Native,
which is pretty darn cool. I don't know any living relative that is the ancient tribe, but some people in my family have said that we were from Mexico, like the Red Indians. And as I kind of look up the native tribes, it kind of showed, I don't know if this is made up or not, but there were branches of the Aztec Indians that broke off to make their own little thing, and one of them was Red Indians. Did not know that. My adoptive mother told me that, which is pretty insightful. And when I was born, they tested my blood. And I was born in the 80s. So, well, 88 to be specific. And so they didn't have to lick my skin to prove it. They had to do a little test, in which case the doctors kind of thought that I was sick at first. And it took them 5 months that I wasn't just getting the baby flu like any other little babies. I was actually sick. And one doctor wised up and sent my mom, my birth mother, to a specialist. And he tested the DNA. So he said,
she's not just sick,
you know, she actually has a disease that's basically gonna shut down her entire body. And that's when we found out that I have cystic fibrosis. I was technically diagnosed at 5 months old. And they were like, well, she's not gonna live that long. Might as well just prepare a tiny little coffin and have a little funeral. Not gonna live. She's to see the age of 2. And as I got older, obviously I'm still here, and they predicted my death at least like 3 more times when I was little. And as you can see, I defied all of them. And as you can also see that I was supposed to have perished in a house fire back in when I was 5 or 6 years old. And that didn't happen either. It seems like something in this universe
kind of saying,
don't die. Do not die. So, yeah. I'm trying everything I can. Doing all the FDA-approved experimental drugs that they have for me. There is this new one called Symdeko. And it's a pill that you take twice a day. And they're kind of color-coordinated. The yellow ones are for the daytime. And the blue ones are for the nighttime. How easy is that? But the thing is, you have to have each pill with a source of good fat.
Or milk.
Like peanut butter. Or if you're going to eat something that has natural fat in it. Not just added fat. And there's also kind of a little restriction there. I can't have any grapefruits, and I can't have any orange. One type of orange, but I can't remember what it was called. And it's weird. As long as I don't have this sort of type of orange, I'm golden. The sad part is that I love grapefruits. But if I'm gonna take the experimental drug that's supposed to help me, I can't have grapefruits. Why? It's like taking candy away
at
from your
Halloween
kid and said, well, you can't have this. Thank you for trying. That is so sad. Very sad. So, every time when I look at things that have fruit and the ingredients, I have to look for grapefruit. Oh, and I remember the orange name, the kind of orange, Seville.
Seville oranges.
And I have to look for Seville oranges in the ingredients, which is kinda weird. I know. So, I'm gonna try to add more videos that will explain further about the disease, and hopefully you guys can make your own judgments on whether or not partake in you supporting the CF research, because we really could use your help. honestly, it'll help us
more drugs that
breathe better,
or to expand our lung capacity, and maybe even extend our lives just a tiny bit more. Every little penny counts. And it's the Cystic Fibrosis Foundation research, and they have been so fantastic to me. Let me tell you, the CF Foundation has been tremendous to me, and to know that there are people out there that are willing to spend their lives, their spare time, to help people like me is really extremely rewarding. And please, 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 if someone is diagnosed with CF that you may know, don't think of them as contagious, because I've had that happen before, especially when I cough. They walk away, they give me dirty looks, and sometimes they even ask, well, are we going to get the same thing that you get? It's not like the flu. It's genetic disease. Your genetic code from your mama and your papa are the ways to get it. So, there you go. Hopefully I can add more videos and, you know, make a fool out of myself and trying to explain stuff. Goodbye until then, I guess. I don't know how to do a sign-off, so...